evening, folks. Welcome to another night of Hiller Volleyball as your Hopkinton Hillers take on the Frontier Redhawks. Frontier coming in from South Deerfield, Mass., so a long road trip from them. Alongside me tonight is Emma Sweetapple. Welcome back, Em. So the Hillers coming into this game, tied for first place in the Tri-Valley League with Medfield with a 10-1 TBL record. The girls suffered their first loss in the league the other night. They lost to Medfield in three straight sets, a very close match, but a loss nonetheless. We're going to take a quick silence here as they play the national anthem.
Good evening. Welcome to Hopkinton High School for tonight's non-league matchup between the Frontier Redhawks, the defending Division III state champions, and your defending Division II state champions, the Hopkinton Hillers. If everyone could please rise for the playing of the national anthem.
All right. So as we're as you heard in the announcement, the Frontier is the defending Division III state champs, and Hiller's defending Division II state champs. So should be a very good match. Frontier always has a very powerful team. They're perennial Division III state champs. Who do we have out on the floor for the Hillers? With Emma's microphone, but so we've got there we go. So we've got the Gilbert sisters out there with Rachel in the back row, Jen Manning getting ready to check in, and we've got Julia, Sarah, and Annie in the front row. Frontier comes into the match fresh off a 3-1 victory over Amherst Pelham the other night. They're coming in with a 7-0 league record and a 14-3 overall record to go against the Hillers' 11-3 overall record. So Looks to be, on paper, a fairly even match. And only one ref tonight, too.
Oh, that's interesting.
And Rachel Zale will get us underway. A nice knuckleball from Rachel for an ace.
Way to start the game.
And that one just sailed long. Side out. Back to serve is Remy Cannell. Senior and one of the four captains on the team. Nice hit from Julia. Kept alive. Jen Manning, Rachel Setz. Sarah, right down.
Nice spot.
Cross court hit, wall hit. She found the open spot in the court and put it away.
She's a very smart player.
Allie McNulty checking in. She'll go back to serve. Side out for Frontier. Back to serve is Catherine Conlisk. She's a senior. Allie handles that serve. Rachel with an outside set. Nice hit from Abby. Wasn't much Abby could do with that set. And point Frontier. It was a little sloppy. You want to see him hit that ball deep, don't you, on a free hit like that?
Yeah, definitely.
Frontier with a 1-point lead here early in the first set. Manning handling the serve. Rachel with a set to Annie. Frontier's kept it alive.
Ooh.
Oh, double hit. Almost looked like Rachel wasn't paying attention there. She was surprised.
I think she's fully ready for it.
Nice put away. Great hit, Sarah. Side out Hillers. Amanda Gilbert checking in. And Jen Manning will go back to serve. Let's see what Jen does here.
You never know with her.
Is she going to go hard or soft?
I say hard.
Yep. And tipped. Kept alive by Allie. Great arm bar. Oh, Jen just pushes it wide. Great save from Allie.
It was. I did not see that coming. Usually it's Jen who's coming from nowhere.
Yep. And Sarah Conlisk serving. Sarah's a freshman. Oh, no, she's a senior. I'm sorry.
Nice spot.
Side out Hillers. And Courtney checks in. She'll go back to serve. And Taylor coming in as well. Jen keeps it alive. Courtney with a set outside to Abby. Nice block. Back to Abby. And long. Inside out Frontier. Emily Woodward. Back to serve. Yep. That's something you don't see very often.
No.
Jen usually does a great job of returning serves. And nice hit from Amanda. Side out Hillers. Abby Gilbert back to serve. Hillers down two. Nice serve. Side set. And Taylor and Amanda got a piece of it, but hit hard enough to get through the block. Side out Frontier. Rachel Chalik back to serve. Double hit.
Yep.
Frontier with the largest lead of the night, 3 points. A miscommunication there.
What do you call that, the husband-wife?
Yep. Just picking up what Mike and Peter started. I thought that hit the floor.
I did too. Nice pancake.
Nice block. Oh, never made it over the net. So Frontier with a 5-point lead here in the first set. Now you can see the Frontier JV coach giving signs on serving. Is he telling them where to hit it, how to hit it?
Where to hit it. So the 6 positions on the court. So he's giving a number 1 through 6, probably the weakest, what he thinks would be the weakest passer. So not the libero.
Frontier up by 6. And that's long. Side out Hillers. Let's see if the girls can string some serves together here. Sarah Powers checks back in for Manning. Amanda Gilbert back to serve. That was going long.
Yeah, I think it was.
Jen checks back in. Side out Frontier. Hannah Adams back to serve. Frontier's got a very senior-laden team.
Oh, great hit.
8 seniors on Frontier. Not a single junior, so it's either a couple freshmen, a couple sophomores, and all seniors. And side out Hillers. Annie and Rachel checking back in. Rachel go back to serve. Nice recovery. Great back row hit from Frontier. Rachel outside to Julia.
Nice spot.
Nice topspin hit. Oh, nice save.
Jen.
Oh, just hate out. To see that wasted.
Yeah.
Great effort from Manning.
Good hustle.
Side out Hillers. Allie checking back in. She'll serve. Hillers down 5 here in the first set. That one just makes it over.
Nice pass.
Rachel outside
to
Annie.
Nice set. Nice hit.
Great black block from Sarah.
Just over the block.
And double hit. Hillers down 4. Let's see if Allie can string together a few more points here.
Nice quick.
Nice block from Sarah.
Oh,
another
Jen
nice block.
Right there.
Great play from Manning. And it was tipped, but Jen couldn't get to it. Side out. Frontier. Catherine Konslick back to serve. By McNulty. Rachel with a push over to Abby. Oop. Nice.
Nice up. Well, that was a nice little move.
Yeah.
By Rachel.
Frontier up by 6. Sarah put that one into the net. Rachel outside to Abby. Oh, there should have been a
nice.
Free chance for a free hit there.
Yeah.
Oh, short set, punch long.
I think that was a little too short
of
a quick set. Just a little bit higher.
When that's done right, it's so hard to defend.
Oh, yeah. You just don't have time to get to where you need to be.
Nice smart play at the net from Sarah Konlisk. She'll go back to serve. Just a quick push over. Hopkinton wasn't ready for it. Another nice block. Well, I guess it wasn't a block. It was into the net.
No, I thought that was a block.
It's always so tough to see with the through the up official.
Yeah.
Hiller's down eight. Block.
Oh, I thought I was in that.
I'm giving Amanda the block.
Yeah.
Courtney checks in. She'll go back to serve. Hiller's down seven. Another quick set. Courtney outside to Abby, into the net again. Abby's just not hitting the ball well tonight. Emily Woodward serving.
Nice. Off the block. Through the block.
Abby back to serve, just checking in for the first time tonight.
Oh.
Looks like a little miscommunication on the Frontier side there.
Good for the Hillers. Nice control.
Save. Very nice save from Frontier.
Uh-oh.
Nice hit from Jess. Kept alive. Manning to Courtney.
And nice hit.
Nice put away from Amanda.
That nice to little, end a play like that.
Yeah, that had a little oomph behind it.
It did.
Miller's down five. Handled well by Manning. Outside to Taylor, and that's long. Mm-hmm. Just try to place that one deep. It's a little too hard. Rachel Chalik back to serve. 22-16, Frontier in front. Manning handling the serve. Courtney with a set to Amanda. Nice hit for Amanda. Sarah Powers checks back in. Amanda will go back to serve.
Ooh,
get over. Whoa.
Just over.
Rode the line.
She got lucky on that one. Ooh.
And that sails long.
Good idea.
Nice serve.
Great long serve. This is some good pressure serving.
Nice job handling that net serve. by Frontier outside to Jess. Blocked, kept alive. Courtney again to Jess.
Nice.
And this time she puts it away.
Great spot.
Hiller's within two. Coach Sean McDonald's going to call timeout for Frontier, see if he can stop the momentum. Amanda's put together a nice string of serves here.
She has. Coming back.
Now, what is Coach Grabmeier saying in the huddle right here?
Probably start strong, stay strong. Just telling them make their serves. This is a time in the game where you cannot miss your serves.
Just keep it in play.
Yep, just keep it in play. Nothing fancy.
Hiller's down two, 22-20. Amanda with the serve. Another nice deep serve, and there's an ace.
Right off her hands.
What's harder to return from a serve? One like that, that's a line drive, or a knuckleball coming in?
Knuckleball.
Yeah.
Because you just sometimes you don't know where it's going to go. Could just shift direction.
Taylor with a set outside to Jess. Nice hit from
Jess.
Hit. And we're tied up at 22.
Way to bring it back. Got a good crowd here today.
Yeah, good attendance even from South Deerfield here for Frontier.
They're actually staying the night.
Oh, really?
Yeah, tomorrow's the Medfield tournament.
Ah, the play date.
Yeah, so they just every year schedule the game around the same time. So that way, they're already here.
Hiller's with a one-point lead.
Way to keep it off the net.
Out caught the line.
I thought that was out.
Because I think either a year or two ago that the girls had a pizza party for the Frontier girls.
Yeah, Margie always tries to put together a dinner for them. So tonight they're, I think they're going to TJ's. Nice bonding experience for the two teams.
Manny handles the serve. Abby with a back row hit, well struck, kept alive. Back row hit from Frontier. Manning with a great dig. Jess with a hit, and nice.
Nice, through the block.
Okay, let's see if Rachel can end the first set here.
Oh, this is really pressure serving. This is the serve you do not want to miss.
Set point here. Rachel keeps it in play. Nice block at the net from Sarah. Jess, Rachel outside to Taylor. Or no, that was Annie,
Annie,
I'm sorry. Tipped at the net.
Nice pass.
Rachel. Sarah, and that's it. First set.
Puts it away.
That was
nice comeback.
Very nice comeback from the girls. They're down by eight at one point, and they come back to take the first set, 25-23. The girls will switch sides. A very, very impressive showing here.
Yeah.
Started out a little ragged. Plays a little sloppy.
Just getting warmed up.
So as I said, the girls are coming off a 3-0 loss to Medfield the other night. And as you said, it was a very close.
Very close good game.
Match.
Yeah, first set went to 29-27.
So that technically puts Medfield in first place, even though they have the same league record When Hopkinton won, they won 3-1, so they lost a set, whereas Medfield swept Hopkinton. So the girls, if they win out and hope Medfield can take a loss, they'll win the league.
Yep.
And Emma's, your freshman girls
are
right next to the crow's nest, and are you getting heckled?
A little bit. Oh, there they are.
And they're having a good season.
They are. Yep. Only lost once, Algonquin. I think they're putting them together.
And when I looked at Max Preps today, too, I don't understand the state rankings, because they have Hopkinton 13th, but they have Medway ahead of Hopkinton and Medfield behind Hopkinton, so I can't figure it out.
Yeah. Sometimes coaches aren't always the best about putting them in.
Yep.
Margie, I think, does it first thing when she gets home, but I think some coaches miss some games. I think I'm still on Max Preps 4 years later.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
And here come the stats. We just got confirmation from Mike Tarosian.
I am still on Max Preps. Oh, awesome. We got stats.
So, here's some of the stats from the first set. Kills, we have Amanda with 3, Jess with 3, Sarah with 3, and Abby and Julia with 1. Assists, Courtney with 6 and Rachel with 3. Digs, we have Jen with 10. Abby has 5. Allie and Courtney have 2 apiece, and then Amanda, Jess, and Rachel each have 1.
Nice.
And so, as we get ready for the second set out here, we've got Jess, Sarah, and Annie in the front row, and Rachel, Jen, and Abby. Oh, actually, Sarah's in the back. Rachel's up front. Oh, and the second ref shows up.
Ah, there we go. Only an hour later.
And we're underway here in set 2.
Oh.
Not sure what Annie was doing there.
I don't know. It's a very good question. Always want to watch the ball.
And that's Raimi Cannell serving. Nice knuckleball. Manny with a back row hit. Rachel with a back set to Sarah. Nice dig from Frontier.
Yep.
Sarah got a nice block on it, but it was just pushed wide.
Missing the coverage over there.
Covering, yep.
Yeah.
Nice serve.
That was a great
That's gonna
serve.
Be trouble.
Yep. Not pretty, but it works. Nice
Great
block.
Rachel with a set to Sarah. Nice block.
That would have been a great serve
if
it was in.
Good eyes from Sarah and Annie. Allie coming in for Jess, and Allie will go back to serve.
Mm-hmm.
Good serve from Allie. Good body control from Rachel. I thought she was going to.
Yeah, I did too.
Get sucked into the net, but she was able to contort her body enough to stay out of it.
Good balance.
And back to serve for Frontier is Catherine Conlisk. Frontier with a 3-point lead here in the second set.
Nice pass.
Back to Abby. Nice hit.
That was
kept
a great
alive
hit.
By Frontier. And nice cross court hit from the back.
Abby has great form. They're hitting and serving.
Tipped at the net. Oh, nice,
nice
put back
block.
By Sarah. Side out Hillers. Manning back to serve. Amanda checking in, replacing Sarah. Good dig from Frontier. Net violation.
Yeah.
Annie. Yep. That was tipped.
Yeah.
Side out, Hillers.
Touched.
Courtney checking in, and Michaela Pucci coming in for the first time tonight. Courtney back to serve. Hillers down 3 early in the second set. Hopkinton took the first set 25-23. Good block from the Gilbert sisters. Cross-court set to Abby, 4 hits.
Yep.
So most I've seen Abby hit it into the net all season.
Yeah.
Emily Woodward serving and short. Side out Hillers. Abby Gilbert back to serve. And nice from Jess. Miller's down 2. Nice hit from Amanda. Nice topspin on that. That just died.
Oh, great hit.
That was a tremendous hit from number 15, Rachel Chalik. Side out, and Rachel will go back to serve. Frontier back in front by 2. Nice save from Manning. And Pucci
nice.
With a nice hit.
Right off the block.
Sarah checking in. Amanda Gilbert back to serve. Hiller's within one. Oh. Okay.
Close. Good idea.
Amanda kept alive with a nice kick save, but
it's your specialty.
Nobody could return it. Yep. It doesn't matter how you get to it as long as you get to it.
Gotta get you some knee pads.
I'm too old to dive around. Another quick set. Manning handles that. Courtney with a set to Sarah. I thought we were going to take a free hit there, but Pucci set it up. Tip, nice save from Courtney. Pucci puts that one deep. Tipped, kept alive by Abby. Just sends that one not as deep as you'd like, but kept it in play. That's the most important thing.
Yep.
Courtney outside to Jess. Down the line, kept alive. Another tip of the net from the Hillers. Manning outside to Jess. Yeah, we almost had our first scoreboard.
Yep. There was one during the JV.
Nice block from Jess.
Nice block.
Nice timing.
Not something you usually see from Jess.
She gets a nice hug from Sarah. Annie checks in as well as Rachel, and Rachel Zale go back to serve. See if Rachel can get this tied up.
Nice serve.
Down the line. Nice put away from Frontier.
Well, she had a little hang time there.
Brianna Thurber, or no, it's Ramey Cannell back to serve. Serves that one wide. Side out Hillers. Allie will check in for Jess, and she'll go back to serve.
Nice try.
Tied up at 10.
There we go.
Net violation. Who's that on? Must have been Abby.
Yeah, I think so.
Catherine Conlisk back to serve. Abby into the net again.
She's a little off today. Nice pass.
Nice block from Sarah.
Going for the pancake, but not quite.
Side out Hopkinton. Amanda checking in. And Jen goes back to serve.
Nice quick. Ooh, that would have been a good hit.
Yep. Good swing, but long. Tied up at 12. And nice play. Amanda just pushed that one over to an open spot. And Coach McDonald calls the first timeout. This set's a much more evenly played than the first set.
Yes, definitely.
Although neither team can really put together a real run of serves. It's
yeah, a little back and forth.
Yep. So there's no common opponent between these two teams either so far this season. So it was tough to gauge
how it would be. Yeah.
Just based on a common opponent. You knew that based on Frontier's history that they'd have a good team. And they do. They're very good defensively. So we've got the Gilbert sisters up front with Annie, and then Rachel, Allie, and Jen Manning in the back row with Jen serving. Hiller's up one. Halfway through the second set. Nice serve from Jen.
A paintbrush.
Yep, a little mishit. Double hit. Yeah, so Hopkinton opening up their largest lead of the set, up by 3.
A nice quick back set.
Great block from Abby.
Those Gilberts.
So the last home game was the Dig Pink Ashland game, and you raised around $1,700, I hear.
Yep. Another great big event.
Great serve from Jen. So they've raised over $10,000 in the 6 years that the annual Dig Pink event has been going on. A great job by the coaches, players, and parents in raising that money for a great cause. Abby pushes that one deep. Back row set, and nice kill from Frontier. Side out. Sarah Conliss goes back to serve. Frontier down 4. Rachel outside to Abby.
Nice block.
Nice block from Annie. And again.
Oh, great.
Great
spot.
Block. I couldn't tell whether Annie got that or Amanda got it.
It was hard to tell.
Courtney checks in as well as Michaela Pucci. Hiller's up 5. Courtney puts that one deep.
Nice hit.
Nice hit. Another great hit from Rachel Chalik. Emily Woodward back to serve. Oh Allie just gets that over for the third hit. Oh, Manning with a great dive. Back row hit from Jen. Gilbert sisters were just a little early leaving their feet there. Net side out.
Nice. I need to control it. Oh.
Another great hit. Tipped to the net by, I think that was Michaela who got a finger on it. Frontier down three. We're going to make a quick substitution. Sarah Corey checks in. Oh. That was floating long.
Yep. Just needed to take a step back. Good call.
They've been working that sideline.
They have.
Side out Hillers. Sarah Powers checks back in for Jen Manning. Amanda Gilbert serving. That should be a free hit. Oh, nice recovery from Frontier, and they take advantage of it.
Yep.
Manning checking back in. Hannah Adams back to serve. Abby handles that serve. Courtney with a set to Michaela. Kayla pushes that one back in. Manning sends it over. Ooh.
That was a good
I don't know
fake
if that
out
was,
attempt.
Yeah, I'm not sure if that was planned or not. Rachel Zale checks in, goes back to serve. Hiller's up three late in the second set.
Just over.
I thought Jess was going to take that on a quick hit.
Yeah. Oh.
Nice put away.
They caught us on the long. Well, they're keeping the matches close, that's for sure.
I think they're working up their appetite for dinner at TJ's.
Yeah. I think it's spaghetti and meatballs.
Ramey Cannell. Manning, back row hit to Gilbert. Nice put away
hit.
From Jess.
Great spot.
Allie McNulty checks in. She'll go back to serve. Hill is up 22-19. And nice put away from Sarah Conlisk.
Nice serve. Oh, nice
well
hit,
done,
Annie.
Annie.
Just over the block.
Hiller's 2 points away from taking the second set. Oh, Coach McDonald's going to use his last timeout of the set. So while we've got a moment, we'll want to thank the outstanding HCAM crew that we've got tonight on cameras down on the floor. We've got Bob Hamilton and Matt Bird. And then up here in the crow's nest, we've got Andy Ritz. And directing tonight is John Ritz. And then we've got the ubiquitous Mike Tarosian doing everything else. It's got a U and a Q in it. Mike's challenging me on the word ubiquitous. Yeah, if everybody at home heard the voices in my head. We'll see if Jen can get two quick serves here and end the second set.
Do you think she'll go long or short on this
short.
One? Short.
Coming out of a timeout.
Yep.
She's been going long. She'll go short.
I think you're right.
Nope. Well, mm-hmm. In between.
Medium. Good spot.
It's a set to Abby. Nice save from Frontier. And nice back row hit.
Yeah.
Side out Frontier. Sarah Conlisk back to serve. Manning handling the serve. Oh, the four hits. Man, this didn't clear the net.
Coming back. 1 point.
Tipped the net. Manning handles that. Rachel with the set outside to Gilbert. Nice. Blocked but wide. Side out Hillers. Set point. Courtney and Michaela checking in. Courtney will go back to try to close out the second set. Allie to Courtney to Abby.
Nice.
Tipped, and that's it.
Great hit.
Hopkinton takes the second set, 25-22, to go up 2-0. Girls will switch sides.
All right. I think I should head down there.
Yes. Thank you for filling in tonight, Emma.
Thanks
appreciate it.
Thanks for having me. I will be back.
So the girls' next home game is, I think, Wednesday night. Bellingham or Holliston comes to town. And then I believe the following Friday is senior night with Millis in the field house. So once again, a very close second set, just like the first set. It's kind of what we figured was going to happen tonight. Both teams evenly matched. Hey.
Hey, Steve.
So, Mike Tarosian, you are the jack of all trades.
I'm going to, might as well fill in. It's beautiful hearing Emma back and getting her insight that we can't give because she's been there. She's been down on that court playing for that coach. Yeah, thank you very much. And look at that. The statistics have made it. All right, so this is for this set.
Yep.
So in the kill department, Abby leads with three. I believe, is that? Yeah, that's a two. All right.
No, that's a four.
That's a, oh, let's take a two, see. Amanda has two.
Oh, yeah, yep.
And Jess, Annie, and Michaela all have one. Aces, we have Rachel with five. I'm sorry.
Assist.
Rachel has five, and Courtney has three. And
blocks.
Yeah. Blocks. Two's all around for Amanda, Jess, Annie, Sarah, and Abby has one. And in the dig department, which everyone saw, I can't believe there's only six. It seemed like more than six digs.
Yeah.
For Jen Manning. Fall right behind with Abby with five. So they're looking good. A lot, that set there was a lot better in the beginning, more even. From what I could tell,
yeah, it was.
The graphics. It's hard. I get to watch a little TV, and I'm changing the score back there, and you really can't watch the game. I mean, you got the best seat in the whole house.
Yep,
is right here on the crow's nest, top center, and we think we could see everything from here, like all the balls are in when they're in and out when they're out. But the referees know best.
And Courtney will get the third set underway. Hiller's up two sets to none. Nice block put right back in play by Frontier. Oh, Manning, look at that.
Wow.
Laid out. Free hit. Oh, nice save from Frontier. Yeah, great point.
Nice rally there.
Yep, great rally.
Heck of a save from Jen Manning.
Frontier wins the first point of the third set. And that's Raimi Cannell serving.
So again, a little bit of the same story. Frontier drawing first blood with the points.
It's two in a row, Amanda's had trouble returning. And looks like she's getting instructions to go right back to the same spot.
Yep. And we'll get shanked over to the cheap seats.
Yeah, it looks like. I thought Coach Grabmeier was going to make a quick change there.
She has a vicious approach.
Yep. Nice block. Side out Hillers. Net violation, or fourth hit.
Fourth hit.
Jess checks in. Abby back to serve.
Little hesitation.
I was just going to say that. Jess looked like she did a little cha-cha there. Started, right. Stop, and
I think she was expecting Jen to come in from the back.
I think we all expect Jen to just appear and
that's the thing,
hit the ball. Oh, just long.
Yep. Not very much.
Just missed.
Yeah, Jen sort of reminds me of the Kelly Leap of the Bad News Bears. Everywhere the ball goes.
Ace.
That's where she is.
Frontier opening up a 6-point lead here.
Yeah.
Correction, okay. 7. And Coach Grabmeier calls a quick timeout here.
Yeah, I think she needs to make some adjustment there. Is it me or does the team seem to get further and further out on the court on their timeouts lately?
Yeah.
Before they were like
almost in
right
on the bench.
Right. And now they're almost at midcourt. All right. I just want to see if it wasn't me. So some good news in the TVL. The field hockey team, they got a point and
they now qualify
for tournament as well as soccer. Soccer tied at, what was it? Tied at 0, I think it was.
And the boys tonight?
Girls.
Oh, the girls.
So yeah. I haven't heard
the boys,
boys
are playing
yet.
Right now.
Boys are up now, right. So the boys need a point.
They need a couple points. A
couple?
Yeah.
Okay.
And good eyes from Manning.
Perfect.
Amanda Gilbert serving. Oh, Sarah blocked that. Yeah, I thought it was four hits.
Yeah, that was four.
Yeah.
Yep.
That's why I was confused.
I was wondering, well, how come it's not coming up yet? Nice line.
Courtney with the set to Sarah. Nice put away. Miller's down by 4. Oh, I thought the girls had that blocked. Side out Frontier. Manning checks in.
Rachel Chalek with the nice spike.
Emily Woodward serving, handled by Pucci. Courtney with the set to Jess. Oh, kept alive nicely by Frontier. Courtney outside, not much Jess could do with that. Great body control. Courtney with a back set to Pucci. Nice swing from Michaela.
Oh, that was risky.
Uh-oh. Frontier back out in front by 5-6.
That's out. Oh.
Yeah, that was in.
All right. You're on that side.
Yep.
I'll take your word for it. I got this TV and microphone
in
the way.
The boom mic was in
the way.
Yeah,
the boom mic's in the way. Thank you. Yeah, they called her on the net violation. Not that it helped. That's a nice fake there.
Yeah.
That worked out. Now we just got to finish. Right.
Another net violation. So Frontier starting to run away with this third set. And that's out. Side out, Hillers.
Yeah, this has been the most uneven.
Taylor and Rachel checking in. Rachel go back to serve. Manning on the floor. Taylor with a nice hit down the line, kept alive by Frontier. And that's out.
Oh.
What?
They called it a net violation. Wow.
On
Taylor.
Who?
Oh. Yeah, Taylor.
And I noticed the volleyball state champ banner is up.
I didn't even see it. Oh, there it is. Wow. Wow. They must have. Oh, they did some shifting over there. They moved the track down.
Got it.
Maybe John can have Matt get a shot of the volleyball banner.
I was wondering when that was going to go up.
Yep. And the Tri-Valley one's up as well. Think Matthew has it yet? There it is, right there. State championship. Thank you, Maddie.
Nice hit.
Perfect.
Second chance, Abby put it away. Frontier's been doing more quick sets than any other team so far that the Hillers have played, and the girls are handling it fairly well.
Right.
So that's a difficult one to defend against if you don't see it a lot.
Yeah, they haven't seen it, well, at home anyways. I know they haven't seen it, but the Hopkins really hasn't used it that much to their advantage.
That's
either.
True. Ah, nice dig from Brooke. And another great put away from Abby.
Gilbert just nails it.
Hillers down by six. See if Brooke can string together a nice run here. Tipped, but looks Hillers out. Couldn't control it. Side out for the Red Hawks. Sarah Corey serving. Abby looked like she wanted to let that one go.
Yep.
It was staying in, though. Manning handling that serve. Outside set to Abby.
Nice hit.
Nice arm bar. And nice hit from Sarah. Side out, Hillers.
Much needed side out at this time. Now we need to get Jen on her serving spree here and chalk up a couple, 3-4 points. Take the edge off. After having like three net violations so close, I don't think she took any chances.
Nope. Catherine Conlisk serving. Oh, double.
Yep.
Wasn't anything. Nope. Coach Grabmeier.
Hopkins timeout. Sure.
Using her second timeout here, trailing by 10.
When you get 10, when you get 10 points, normally, when the games are
that far away.
Yeah. Well, even when it seems like it's a lot more closer, then all of a sudden, you have the breakaway of points, and you get to 8, you have that timeout. But this thing here, it's not that fast pace of a game.
No. Right.
It just seems like a lot of lack of a better term is lobs. It's just taking its time.
Yeah, we haven't had that many long rallies.
No.
Let's see if the girls can show that same grit and determination they did in the first set.
Right. That was a great comeback.
Oh, and there's an ace. And he's checking in for Taylor. Rachel outside to Abby. Blocked. Nope. Didn't make them clear the net.
Four hits.
Hiller's down by 12. I don't think I've said that in a long time.
No, if anything, it was 3 or 4 years ago. And usually there's some blue shirts on them.
Yes, yeah. That's what I was going to say. It had to have been Medfield. Nice arm bar from Brooke. Manning keeps it alive. And he punches it over. Another quick set kept alive by the Matrix.
Yeah, I had to correct Tom on that one.
Why is that?
Well, I think what he was looking for, I know he's referred to the Matrix, but I think he was looking for Trinity. Is what he was trying to get out of it. The flying crow, whatever thing, whatever she did, and the camera turns. And yeah, Matrix sounds better.
Did Tom agree with you?
Oh, he did, yeah.
Okay.
He couldn't.
I'm sticking with Matrix.
He couldn't remember the name. And because he said it twice, and I says, "Are you thinking about Trinity?" Oh yeah, that's it. Yep.
Manning handling another serve, set to Annie. She paintbrushed that one, but it worked.
Yep. It's not too often we get 2 paintbrushes in a game.
Right. And for those of you that don't know what a paintbrush is, that's when you go to hit the ball with your hand open and you swing and you just catch it with your fingertips.
And it rolls backwards.
Right. Rolls your fingers backwards, so it's like painting.
One of our more favorite terms.
I like the arm bar.
Arm bar is a good one. I like the pancake, husband, wife.
So Frontier is coming close to closing this one out here. They're at set point. Ramey Cannell trying to close it out here.
Not going to do it like that.
Nope.
Well, if it goes that way, it looks like I have to pay the crew overtime.
Yeah.
Go into set number 4.
Unless Abby can string together 15 in a row here.
I'm ready.
Ready. There's Manning with an arm bar, but that goes out. So Frontier takes the third set, 25-11. At least the girls got into double digits.
Yeah, they did get a double digits. It was,
so it was a little face saving there.
For lack of better terms, it was an ugly set.
Yep.
I wasn't impressed with either play from either team.
No.
But, you know, obviously Frontier did better, answered better. They were better on their service.
Much better on their defensive end.
Without a doubt. Oh, look, there's your part-time co-host there, Peter Bransfield, coming up.
He makes it
in. Coming up the stairs, yeah. A little late there, Pete.
Probably stuck in traffic again.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's that 84 thing is kind of tough. No? Doing wonderful, Peter. How are you? You just traffic hold you up? Having like a little HK reunion here. Andy Ritz and Peter Bransfield coming back. And pretty impressive. And poor Matt's tired down there. You all right, buddy?
The young ones need a break.
Yeah, he's getting tired down there. You tired? Sleepy? A little pillow? Oh, you know what? They can hear us now.
I know.
The new technology, the talent, the talent is now in the ears of the intercoms. And just like the director's the voice inside our heads here. So let's see what kind of changes are made for set number four. Do we go back to the starters? Do we go back to, you know, put this thing away?
Yep.
Because, you know, the spaghetti meatballs are going to get cold.
Yep. Somebody might have to call TJ's.
Trying to get Peter to come here and talk the last set with you, but I don't know. He might be tired from his drive.
So out there on the floor, we've got in the front row, Annie, Sarah, and Jess, and then Abby, Sarah, and Rachel in the back row. Or no, that's Amanda.
That's Amanda. And then we get Jen coming in for
our stats.
Outstanding. And our wonderful managers are back on top of everything with these stats. Thank you, girls. Guys are awesome. A lot of goose eggs on here.
it's a fairly empty stat sheet.
This is too big of a piece of paper, what they handed me. The kill departments, Annie, Sarah, and Abby all have two. In the blocks, there were two, one with Michaela and Amanda. Each had one. But in the assists, Rachel with four, Courtney with one. And Jen did a lot of flying around the matrix there with the seven, and followed up by Brooke with three and Abby with two.
Yeah, Hopkinton's having trouble returning serves.
Yeah, and I think you talked about it earlier, how the assistant is giving the signals on where to send it. Normally, a lot of people that watch the volleyball on TV, especially the beach volleyball, a little Chester there. In the beach volleyball, usually the other teammate is given a position where it is.
Yep.
But here the assistant holds up his iPad and blocks it so they can see it, and he tells what position, you know, six positions on the court. He just holds up his hands and the server takes a look, and that's where it's going to go.
Frontier with a two-point lead here. Beginning of set number four. And into the net for
a side out. Yeah, she was going for one of those little ropes that just touches the net and throws it off a little bit. Throws off your approach to defend it.
Allie McNulty checking in. She goes back to serve. And tipped and kept alive. Back row hit. From Cannell.
Oh. Just hit a little too late.
Side out. to the Red Hawks. Sarah Conlisk goes back to serve. Abby handles that. Rachel with the set back to Abby. Down the line. Nice put away.
Yeah, she was more about protecting the face on that
yep.
shot.
Jen Manning back to serve. Hiller's down one. Oh, nice. Nice serve. That climbed up and over the net. Allie McNulty doing her Jen Manning imitation. Diving on the floor. Abby with a nice dig.
She's always
outside.
Smiling when she dives.
Oh, Jen Manning, nice. Great play. Oh, just wide.
That was a great move because she called Dumas off.
Yep. Hit, nice swing from Annie. And we're tied up at four.
Now this looks like, you know, set number two all over again.
Yep. Back and forth.
All right, so Hiller girls soccer picked up 2 points. 3-0 win over Bellingham. And it was senior night.
Yeah. Yeah, I think the boys have to win out.
Yep. Hiller football is up 6-0 in the first quarter.
Courtney with the set to Amanda. Nice swing from Amanda. Well placed and with power. Oh, that was a nice hit. Rachel Chalik. And looks like she'll go back to serve. Red Hawks within one. That's going to be tough. Set
what?
Was
no.
Courtney's set was too close to the net for Amanda to do anything with it.
Mm-hmm.
Other than to go into the net.
Right.
Tied up at six.
She's seen enough of that tonight.
Yeah. Nice serve. Handled by Manning. Allie just has to hit it over. Yeah. Nice try. Pucci got a hand on it, but couldn't control the block. Frontier back out in front by one.
What's going over? Oh.
No. Courtney, you got to watch the ball. It's a nice serve.
Nope. Couldn't get under it enough.
Looks like Coach Grabmeier might take a timeout here. Yeah. Yep, she is.
That's right. Yeah, It's looking sloppy like the third set. Yep. When it should be looking like the second.
Yep. Can't let it get too far out in front.
No. Slice the server a little bit.
So the girls' next home game is next Wednesday, Holliston.
Next Wednesday at Holliston comes here. And then the last home game is Friday with
senior night
with Millis. And then, of course, we should be bringing you some playoff action.
Yep.
At least one at home. Love the postseason play. And what do you think? You want to take the show on the road? Well, head on the road and we'll...
Yeah, well, we did every game did last year, didn't we?
Every away game, postseason game. And we did... Oh, that was basketball. We're starting... As the interest gets there with the volunteers willing to go,
there's an ace.
We're looking to cover more away games, and I think next football season we're gonna do the away games as well.
Oh wow!
Because this year here, there was only two games this year, and the third game is gonna be Thanksgiving, which is every other year.
Manning on the ground again. And that's four hits. Side out Hillers.
Yeah, that could have been a huge collision in the backcourt between Manning and Alley. You know, Jen got to it first, which was still playable. That was nice. But, oh, my goodness, you see them smashing in and someone getting hurt.
Yeah.
That would be devastating to the team.
Jess checks in.
That's Oh, wow.
You hate to see that.
Yeah, that was your chance right there. That was your chance.
Yeah, I just realized Aaron's not here. Windsor.
Oh, yeah. You are correct.
Nice block.
Block. Wow.
I think that was Jess again.
I think so. I believe you are correct.
Sarah Powers checks in.
Still trying to figure out how I could put cameras on the net. Working on it. And that's it.
Yeah, nice ace. Maybe a little GoPro right on the antenna.
Well, that's what we're talking about. I was talking over with one of our favorite officials, Alan. And not only favorite officials, but one of our biggest fans of HCAM. We're discussing methods of doing it. And I think...
Nice hit.
And I think if we put it on the far post, facing the ref on the ladder, you know, we'll get something, and then at least you get the signals, too. It'll just give you a different view. There is a way to do the GoPros through the Wi-Fi, but you're just going to see how the image looks. So we get some testing to do soon.
Hillers down four here in the fourth set. Red Hawks serving. Brooke handles that one. Outside set to Pucci. Nice put away from Michaela. Nice swing. Side out Hillers. Annie and Rachel checking in. Zale will go back to serve.
Checking rotations, it looks good.
Nice knuckleball from Rachel. Nice pull back. Brooke just pushes that one over. Nice quick set. That was, wow. You could see that coming.
Yep. Yeah, she had that in the corner of her eye, that open spot. She knew right where she was hitting it.
Hiller's down four.
Just wasn't sure if that was going to her or
yeah.
not.
Yeah. Kept alive by Brooke. Set outside to Jess. Into the net.
Wow, what a block. Said Rachel Chalek.
Yep. And Ramey Cannell back to serve. He's got a very good serve. Handled well by Sarah. Jess just pushes that one. Good handle by Brooke. Outside to Annie. Oh. Manning. Zale. And to Annie. Oh, double hit.
What a
good reaction hit from yeah. Frontier, but.
More of a carry than a double hit.
Yep.
Yes, that's what they call. Looked like a double.
Abby and Allie checking in. McNulty got all that one. That
and
was over
some.
The that was over the green monster
and
seats.
And then some, yeah, yeah.
Side out.
That ball made it to TJ's before the team did. Again, sloppy on the communication
yeah, they are.
Over there.
Yep. Down six. Nice block at the net by number 11, Sunny Hunter. Side out.
There you go, right here. This is where you need to. This is where you need to close the gap. I tell you, you know, if she gets 3 points, I know they're gonna call a timeout over there.
Yeah.
So. Oh.
Curse of the announcer.
Mm-hmm.
Side out, Frontier.
I didn't say she was gonna do it. I said this is what you needed. She's trying to be optimistic. Nice shot.
And that's out. Good eyes from Annie.
Yeah, great job by ball on that one.
Courtney and Michaela checking in. Courtney back to serve. That's a very nice hit. Rachel Chalek, she'll go back to serve. She swings, very fluid motion. Manning handles that serve well. And then Manning again.
Oh.
And that was in. Jen thought it was going long. Well, she's pleading
well,
she didn't hit it.
She was, yeah, she was thinking that they were going to get the tip and that it went out. But.
And Coach Grabmeier calls her last time out of this set.
Yeah, you have the 8-point differential. This is where you need it now. This is where they're going to have to come together.
And it looks like we may end up going 5 sets here, based on the way this one's going.
Haven't seen 5 sets in a long time.
Yeah.
Almost forgot. Everyone's going to tell you, even the crew. Crew's saying the same thing.
Yes.
There's some serious height on the frontier, coach, as pointed out by John Ritz. And
Coach McDonald is a tall man. He also coaches a club volleyball team from Frontier.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Yeah.
22-13. Almost had a Gilbert sister collision there.
Mm-hmm.
Abby into the net.
Yep.
Frontier with a 10-point lead. Late in the fourth set.
Oh, it was hard.
We got away with that.
Yep.
That was it.
We'll take it.
Yep.
And that's behind the antenna. Ooh. Ooh.
Yeah, it was
her
ankle.
Ladder. Yeah, let's take her out.
Yeah, you could see it just it buckled.
They don't have the rule when the coach comes out, you got to go off. They do? Yeah, they're going to call a timeout. There you go. You know, it doesn't matter how much padding you get around the ladder in these posts. They're still solid. I'm sure they'll get the trainer out there to get a look at her. The ice. I sit up and walk it off. It's like the good old days.
Yep.
Rub some dirt on it. You'll be fine. So 23-14, set number 4.
And we've got Amanda and Abby Gilbert out there with Allie McNulty, Michaela Pucci, Courtney Hassan, and Jen Manning, with Jess Meller checking in for Allie. Courtney with the set back to Jess.
Wow, she got some height on that one.
She did. Courtney back outside to Jess. Nice hit. Wow. And Manning gets there. Give it back to Jess. She's earned it.
Yep.
Right into the and net. Well-earned point.
Yeah, that's what's nice. I mean, with play like that, you got to come out finishing with a point.
Just need 10 more of those. Net violation on Jess. And we're set point now. Sarah Corey back to serve. And we live to fight another day. Sarah Powers checking in. Amanda Gilbert will go back to serve. 24-16.
Nice push by Sarah there.
Outside to Jess. Oh. And on that swing, Frontier takes set number four, 25-16. So we're tied up at two sets. We're going to go to set number five. I'm hungry.
Yeah, you know, I was feeling the same thing. I guess that's all that talk with the spaghetti and meatballs. That'll do it to you. Let's see, just got, well, that's an old one. Trying to get our updates here and everything else going on in the field we have. Just trying to see what's going on out in the field there. Checking the Twitter. And Wi-Fi is not that great in here. Wow. Boys defeated the soccer team. The boys soccer defeated Bellingham 8-0.
I think it was 7-0 the first time they played. Maybe it was 6-0. It was.
And at the half of the Hopkinton and Medfield football game, 21-0 Hillers. Yeah, that's all that's going around tonight. And this, you're watching, you can see it. The dreaded fifth set. 15 points.
What do we have?
So here in the kill department, Abby leads with three. Amanda and Michaela both one apiece. In the blocks, Amanda with two. Jess and Abby with one. The aces, threes are wild with Courtney and Rachel. And in the digs, Jen with five. And Brooke with three. Allie with two. Oh, just did have one in there.
And let's see, on the front row, we've got Annie, Sarah, and Jess. With Jen Manning coming in with Abby and Rachel. And if you're watching at home, could you keep my dinner warm? I'd love you for that.
Of course, the first replay will be 10:30 at night, so they're going to be saying, what? What's he talking about? What's he, a third shifter?
Well, we're going out live.
We are going out live for the people who are watching at home. It's tough to know who's watching at home.
Nice block from Sarah.
In a rare event, Hopkinton puts the first point up.
Yep. Let's string together some serves here, girls. And we might be in the seesaw action here. Side out. Frontier.
This could be a very long 15 points. Is that what you're telling me?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Oh, Annie hit that one.
She had the right idea. She's going for the corner. Just wound up going wide instead.
And here's Julia checking in. Manning gets to it. Jess keeps it alive. That's going over. Put away nicely by Frontier.
Yeah, it looks like Rachel was waiting for the beginning of this rally to put the ball in that spot on the floor.
Remy Cannell serving. Okay, side out Hillers. Let's see what the girls can do here. Alec McNulty's going to check in. Outside to Gilbert and blocked. Side out. Oh, wait a minute. What's the ref saying?
Whoop. Hold on.
Down ref was. Oh, Sarah's gone long. Girls need a side out here. Oh. Allie just tipped that. Tried to pull back. I think it was going long. Coach Grabmeier is going to call a timeout here. Girls are down four. Fifth set's only the first one to 15, or win by two.
Right, they change at seven.
Yep.
So, and very, very quiet crowd.
I was just gonna—I was looking around. The crowd has thinned out somewhat.
Then it thinned. I don't know if people went to go catch the second half of the football game over in. Medfield, which I doubt, but you never know. I've seen stranger.
Sarah Conliss back to serve. Red Hawks with a 4-point lead here over the Hillers. Manning. Zale with a
there
quick pushover. That's it.
Wow. That's the kind of Hiller ball we're used to right there.
Amanda Gilbert checking in. Jen Manning back to serve. Nice hit once again from Chalik. She's been swinging so nice the last three sets. McNulty handles that one. Rachel with a set outside to Abby. Nice hit.
Through the block. Nicely done.
Courtney and Michaela checking in. Going to switch sides here. 8-4. And tomorrow's the Medfield play date.
At Medfield.
At Medfield.
Yes.
So that's an annual event. Gives the girls a little competition against good teams, gearing up towards the playoffs. Side out Hillers. Hillers down three with Abby Gilbert going back to serve. Jess Meller checking in. Alec McNulty goes out. Nice swing. Point for Frontier. Went through the block of Michaela and Amanda. Sarah Corey back to serve. And that's long. Good eyes. I think everybody on the sidelines called that one out.
You're right.
Sarah Powers checking back in. Amanda Gilbert back to serve. Hillers down three. Courtney to Sarah. Sarah, and that's long. Jen Manning checking back in. 10-6. The Red Hawks in front. And nice, smart play from Jess. She saw the double block there and just put it right over the top. Gently placed it. Rachel back to serve. Hillers down three. Nice serve. See if the Hillers can capitalize on this. Oh, nice arm bar. Well, that was a miscommunication, but Frontier was able to put it away.
Yeah, they did benefit well from that. It looked like it was going to be a little quick set and turned up to like it'd be a slip.
Turned into a punch over and it worked.
Yep.
Manning handles that serve. Rachel with a set outside to Jess. Back row hit. Manning on the ground. Nice save.
Oh, just barely over.
Great save from Rachel. Manning with the assist. Side out Hillers. Let's see if that swings the tie the Hillers way. Ellie McNulty enters, and she'll go back to serve. Good serve. And once again, Chalik swings so well.
There's a lot of power behind that swing.
Yeah. Sarah Conlisk serving. Well done, Jen. Once again, that was Chalik. 13-8, Coach Grabmeier calling timeout. It looks like it took Frontier a couple sets to warm up, but.
Sure did.
They have been the better team the last three sets.
Yeah, almost to the point that, you know, I won't call it flawless play, but they seem to set up their offense. There's a lot of movement on the floor outside of the play where the ball is, which is a distraction. They've come up big on every quick set.
Yep.
And, the serving. The serving is there.
Yeah, they don't have a lot of one-and-done serves. They string three or four or more together. You know what I think it is? I think we can blame Peter.
I'll blame Peter. Why not? See, that was Peter's fault right there.
Peter, we're blaming you. They started playing poorly when you showed up.
Ever since you pulled in the parking lot.
All right. Frontier serving for the match.
He'll never come back again. what a
great dive. Oh, Manning as well. Oh, what was the call? Hopkinton point.
What's this? That's
thought that was a chop. Atlanta Braves.
Oh, that's the.
Oh, a carry or a palm?
No. Palm is this. That is. Peter. What's this call? Oh, what could I? I remember you used to know all that stuff. Yeah.
They didn't reach over, though.
No. I don't know. I remember when Peter remembered all this stuff. He was the smart one. Well, he was in school back then. Yeah, he's been away. College rotted his brain.
Nice serve from Manning. Back row hit. And that's it. Frontier takes the third set, 15-10. And they take the match 3-2. It's about what we thought it would be, though. A very, very...
Right.
Well-played match.
Yep.
It was going to be close. So the girls' next home game is next Wednesday. The Holliston Panthers come to town. And then a week from tonight is senior night.
And I also want to plug for the other sport fans. The Tri-Valley League Cheerleading Championship will be held here on Thursday.
So in
between volleyball, come and watch the cheerleaders as they compete.
For Mike Tarosian, Emma Sweetapple, I'm Steve Sweetapple, and the whole HCAMP crew, we bid you adieu.